it's Michelle Melanson. Welcome to Yoga for Cancer. I'd like to thank Carrie Madrid and the CARE Project for sponsoring this program. Everybody get your yoga mats out if you haven't already. Take your yoga blanket, fold it in fourths, and sit towards the front of it so that your sits bones, those bones in your the back of your bottom and hips are kind of pitching you forward a little bit. You can cross your legs. You can put your legs out in front of you, whatever is most comfortable for you. I'm gonna sit with my legs crossed. I am going to straighten my spine, thinking about a string that's going from the top of my head to the ceiling. So my spine is straight and relaxed. So first thing we're gonna do is some breath work. So I want everybody to, if they are comfortable, close their eyes. If not, just look with a soft gaze on the floor in front of you. And we're going to breathe together. Breathing in yoga is called pranayama, which means breath work or breath of life. And we are just going to breathe together. We're going to breathe in 2, 3, 4, 5, and out 2, 3, 4, 5. When you breathe in, notice the air passing through your nostrils and down your throat into and filling your lungs and your belly. And when you breathe out all your cares and your worries, those anxieties that are keeping you bound. And pull your navel in towards your spine and empty out your abdomen and your lungs of all the air. And just breathe in and out evenly for the next couple of minutes. Your hands can be resting on your knees, palm up towards the ceiling, or you can rest them quietly, palm down on your knees, whatever is most comfortable for you. As you're breathing, try to empty your mind of thoughts, especially thoughts that are worrying or bothering you in any way. Just put them outside the door. You can pick them up later if you still want them back, but let's just try to focus on the breath in through your nostrils and out through your nostrils. Relax your shoulders down. Pull those ears away from those shoulders. And just breathe. With our next breath, let's take our heads and bring our chin down towards our chest. And just let it hang there, just chin towards chest. Continue your breathing. You should feel a nice stretch in the back of your neck. pull the shoulders away from the ears. We all tend to bring our shoulders up towards our ears and hold all our tension in our necks and our shoulders. And so it's really important to loosen those up when we're practicing our yoga. And with the next breath in, bring your head up to neutral position and slowly bring your ear towards your right shoulder. So right ear, right shoulder. With this, even as we're pulling our shoulder away from our ear, so we're kind of chasing it, you're going to feel a stretch in the left side of your neck. As you slowly continue breathing in and out, a couple of more seconds on this side. With your next breath in, bring your neck back to neutral, and then slowly start dropping your left ear towards your left shoulder, even as you're pulling your shoulder away. And you should feel that stretch on the right side of your neck. Sometimes I feel it in the back of my neck too. Just breathe into it. Relax and breathe as you feel that stretch on the right side of your shoulder, of your neck. More seconds on this side. And with your next breath in, let's bring your head back to neutral and then just let it dangle forward again. And hopefully you don't feel quite so much tension in your neck. And just kind of rock it back and forth a bit. And then bring it back to neutral. Okay. All right, let's do some side twists. That's always a good opener with yoga. So I'm going to take my right hand and I'm going to put it on my left knee. And I'm going to take my left hand and I'm going to put it down beside me. I'm staying nice and tall, remembering that string going up to the ceiling, and I'm going to twist to my left with my waist. So we're twisting with our waist. And breathe. Your next breath, if you can, twist a little more. I'm going to move my left hand a little bit more behind me, and I'm going to twist more with my waist. And breathe. If you can, try to look over your left shoulder, but don't force it. If you can, do so, but if not, it's okay. Just stay where you are. And breathe. And then we're going to gonna slowly come to the front. So slowly walk your left hand forward and bring your right hand back to neutral. Okay, and then we're gonna do it on the other side. In yoga, you always have to do both sides of everything. So left hand is going on the right knee, right hand is going down to the side, and I'm gonna twist at my waist, keeping my back nice and tall. My next breath, I'm going to move my right hand back slightly more, and I'm going to twist more. But just twist to where you're comfortable. Twists are very good for our immune system. They help build it by working the lymph back up through our system via our diaphragm. So the more twists, the better. And with my next breath in, I'm going to look over my right shoulder. If you're able, go ahead. If not, that's okay. Just stay where you are. Slowly come back, bringing that right hand forward slowly and untwist slowly. Okay, now I'm going to move my blanket out. If you are uncomfortable on your knees and you don't want to do things just on your yoga mat, you can unfold and put this blanket down and put your knees on it. I fortunately don't need to do that yet. And I'm going to come down to all fours. So my hands are planted forward underneath my shoulders. My knees are planted under my hips. Okay, my neck is at neutral. I'm going to do some movements called cat cows. Okay, these we're going to do with our breath. So when you think about a cow, with an in-breath, we're going to make our back sway. So we're going to bring our bottom and our hips up and our chest forward. Our head, we're going to keep looking forward, but we're going to have a sway back like a cow. And we do that with an in-breath. And then with our out-breath, we're going to bring our chest down towards our knees and our neck towards our chest. And we're going to push up so we're kind of like a cat that's hissing. And we're going to let our breath out with that movement. So in, we're going to sway our back and bring our chest forward. And out, we're going to let our breath out and bring our chest in towards our knees. And our head towards our chest. So in and out. And do these at your own pace, to your own breath. Thank you. with this because it's good for our hips and our hip flexors. So with the next in-breath, I'm going to add a twist of my hips and a look over my right shoulder. So I'm looking over my right shoulder towards my toes. And then I'll bring it back to center, let my breath out. And then with the next breath in, I'm going to twist my hips to the right and twist my hips to the, to the right and look over my left shoulder towards my left toes. And then we're going to add in one more of a twist that's going to involve our shoulders. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take my left hand and I'm going to put it underneath my right hand. Palm is up and I'm going to go down as best I can on my shoulder. Now you may only be here, that's fine, but you're going to feel a stretch through that arm and through that shoulder. I'm just going to rest there and breathe. And again, this is giving a good twist to the diaphragm, which is helping the lymph system get that lymph fluid back up to the center of your chest where it's reabsorbed. And this helps with the immune system. A couple more breaths here, and then I'm going to push up with my right hand, bring my left hand back up, and because we do everything on both sides, right hand's going to go underneath, palm up, and I'm going to come down onto my right shoulder, or if it's just this far, that's fine. Couple of more breaths here. And I'm going to push up with my left hand, bring my right hand to center, and I'm going to come back on my heels. Now I'm going to show you how to get off the floor, because a lot of people are always like, okay, I got down there, but how do I get up? So we're going to use these blocks. So I'm going to take my blocks and I'm going to put them on the utmost side, so where they're tallest. I'm going to come back up to my knees. I'm putting pressure on my hands on the blocks. I'm going to bring my left foot forward between the blocks. Okay, I'm going to take my right foot and I'm going to curl my toes under. My chest is forward, and I'm going to push up with my toes and with my hands. Bring the other foot between, and then push up and off the blocks. All right. Now we're going to do a series of exercises that are a modified sun salutation. So when when somebody has had breast surgery, a lot of the exercises in yoga are not safe or comfortable to do because of scar tissue, because of implants. So we modify this series called Sun Salutations to get the same effect of, but in a way that is safe. So we're going to use our blocks, and I'm going to bring the blocks to the front of the mat. And I'm going to check to make sure that that height is good. So I'm going to do what we call a chair position. So I'm going to bring my hips back and my hands down to the blocks. I'm watching to make sure my knees, that I can see my toes past my knees. So we're coming down with the knees, but not so that your knees are over your toes, but that your knees are over your ankles. Okay, and make sure you can come down. If not, you might need another set of blocks, and that's okay. Sometimes they can be stacked this way, so you're not coming down quite so far. But the main thing is that you're safe and that you're comfortable. All right, so once you're in this position and you're comfortable, chest is forward, okay? I'm gonna step back with my right foot. My left knee is bent, but again, I'm watching to make sure it's bent over my ankle, not my toes, and my chest is forward. And with my next breath in, I'm gonna bring my toes forward, and I'm gonna push off the blocks and come up. Okay. And then I'm gonna come back down again to the blocks, making sure that my feet are facing forward, that my ankles or my knees are over my ankles, not my toes. My chest is forward, and I'm going to step back with my left foot. And take a couple of breaths there. And with my next in breath, I'm bringing my foot forward and pushing up off the blocks. Okay. I'm going to do that two more times on each side, and then I'm going to change it up a bit. So right foot back, left knee is bent but over the ankle, not the toes, chest is forward, bring the feet together, come up. Time on each side, and then I'll change it up. Putting our knee down. So back down to the blocks carefully, making sure those knees are bent over the ankle, not the toes. I'm going to go back with my right foot. Chest is forward, left knee is bent. And then I'm going to come down on my right knee. And then with my next breath in, I'm going to come up, come back down to my blocks. My toes are curled under on the right side, so use them to push back up, foot forward, and back up. As you can see, you get lots of arm movements with this exercise, as well as a little exercise going on. So I step back with my left foot, left knee down. When I'm ready, I push up off the blocks, back down to the blocks, toes curled under, push up, step forward, and back up. All the time breathing. I'm going to do that two more times on each side, and then I'm going to change it up again. So step back, knee down, when I'm ready. toes under, push up, push forward. All right. One more time. Whoops. We're going to add a little twist in and then come back up. So, okay, now we're going to go down, knee bent, and we're going to twist to the same side. So right foot back, right knee down, blocks on either side of the forward foot. I'm going to put my weight on the left block, right knee is back. And I'm gonna lift away and up. So I'm twisting towards the right. With my next breath, I'm gonna come down. Toes are twisted under on that right side. Foot comes up, foot between the blocks. Up. Same thing, I'm gonna come down. Left foot's gonna go back, chest is forward. Come down on that knee, and when I'm ready, I let go with my left arm and I twist up to the left. Trying to keep that right knee straight towards the front, and careful again that it's over the ankle, not over the toes. Back down, step up, step forward. Okay, I'm gonna do it two more times on each side. And then we'll move on. So back with the right, back down with the right, up with the right arm, and stretch forward, keeping that left knee up. Back down, step back up, step forward, back up. Time on each side, I think. Our little energizing part of our exercise. We're going to do a couple of standing exercises, and then we're going to do some exercises for balance. So when we're doing standing exercises, always try to stand with your feet hip width apart, toes facing forward. It can be, you know, I'm going towards the side of the mat because that's where the camera is, but you can do it towards the front of the mat. Okay, but important thing is the feet are forward. You're gonna plant your toes, so you're gonna kind of spread your toes, put your weight towards your big toe, and then on the from the little toe all the way back into the heel, so that you're very planted when you're doing standing exercises. Okay, so we're going to take our hands and just have them forward. Our spine is straight, our buttocks are tucked, and this is mountain pose. And then we're going to just take our arms up again and bring them up together above our head, or as best you can, and back down. And then twist the hands backwards and again. tree, so we're going to take our right arm and bring it up gracefully. So that's pointed basically over the top of our head with our fingers spread. If it's to the side, some that's fine. And then we're going to take our left hand and put it on our left thigh, and we're just going to bend down towards the left. Just running that hand down towards the knee with a bend to the left. And breathe. Bring that back, and we're going to switch. So right hand is on the right thigh, the left arm up over the top, and we're just going to sway like a palm tree down towards that left side. And you'll feel a stretch in the left, and of course I'm going to the right, not the left. That's what makes me lovable. I get my sides mixed up sometimes. And breathe. And bring it back down to center. Okay. All right, let's do some exercises. I think here is fine. That are going to work on our balance. There's a couple of different ones. I'm going to do one with the block and one without. So I'm going to start with the one that's without. So, Carrie, I guess, can you get me? So I'm going to do a warrior three, but I'm going to do it against the wall. So I'm going to bend so that my back is straight with my hands against the wall. My feet should be again firmly planted. Hands firmly planted in your back like a tabletop. And with your next breath in, you're going to shift your weight to the left foot. And once the weight is shifted onto that left foot and that left leg is strong and holding all your weight, you're going to lift your right foot in the air, knowing all the time how strong your left leg and foot are. They're holding all your weight. You're just kind of leaning against the wall. Get that foot up in the other leg, the right leg in this case, up in the air. And breathe. And slowly bring that back down. Plant it firmly. So that the toe is planted, the outside of the, from the little toe back to the heel is firmly planted. And we'll start to move the weight over into that right foot. And when the weight is there and you can feel it, your thigh strong and steady, then you're going to slowly lift that left leg up into the air. Back is flat, hands against the wall, but mostly your weight is in that right leg. And this is good for building strength in your leg, but also for balance. And I can tell I have not been doing my balance exercises. Okay, and then bring it down slowly and push off the wall. Whew. Now I'm going to do some exercises, balance exercises using your block. So everybody should have blocks. If you don't, Carrie has some here, and I'll make sure there's more here. So if you don't have equipment at home, please give Carrie a call, and she will assist you with that. So I'm going to put this against the wall, kind of, probably about 6 inches out from the wall. I use the wall. The wall is there for balance, okay, to get started. So I am going to stand next to the block, straight. I'm going to be looking ahead, I'm going to take my, in this case, my left foot up and put it on the block. And that's it. We're just going to do that for now. We're just going to feel, how does that feel? How does it feel to put more of the weight on the left foot? And it's up off the floor, so let's just kind of feel that out and see how that feels. Okay. I'm going to now carefully put my hand against the wall because I'm going to come up on my right toes. And I'm just going to stand there and see how does that feel. So my balance is being affected by that left foot on the block. Okay. I want it firmly and solidly planted there, but I'm balancing on those right toes. And if and when you feel ready, you can pick those toes up. I'm going to have to move this out a little more. Make it more like 8 inches from the wall. And I'm going to just bring my foot up and I'm going to drop my hand, but you do what feels comfortable to you. That's why the wall's there, to help with the balance. So I'm balancing on the block with my left foot and my right foot is at my ankle. Okay. If you're not comfortable with that, you can just leave it still on your toes on the floor. You'll build this with time and practice. If you're feeling comfortable, you can bring it up below your knee or above your knee, but not on your knee. Okay. And if at any point you're not comfortable with it, just move it back down. You can put those toes on the floor. No falling. That's why the wall's there, so it's there to give you that extra sense of safety, and that's okay. We want to increase our balance, but we want to do it in a safe way. Okay, and after you're about a minute on that side, it's okay to turn and do it on the other side. Not okay, it's important to turn and do it on the other side, so I just turn around. Do my right foot on the block and I just kind of stand there again, just getting that feel. How does that feel? Does it feel like it's well planted on the block? And when I'm comfortable, I'll come up on my toes, and you can use the wall if you need to when you come up on your toes, and just be up on your toes for a while. It's okay. And then when you're comfortable, you can bring that left foot to your ankle or your calf below the knee, or you can bring it up into the groin or above the knee, but not on the knee. That's not safe for your knee. And just breathe. About a minute. Slowly put my foot down and then step off the block. That's an excellent exercise you can do at any point in time during the day. I know balance can definitely be a problem when you've had treatment for cancer, so it's important to build our balance. And even if you know you're a loved one that's practicing with your loved one with cancer, everybody can benefit from balance work. Okay. I am going to do a couple of restorative poses, maybe just one, looking at the time. I'm going to use my block You can use your blanket if you're more comfortable. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put it right here on my backside. I want it below on my spine, but below the main part of my spine here. So I'm going to sit down. And you can use your blocks to get down too, by the way. If you have trouble getting down, you can get down with your blocks. Put your blocks apart. Use your weight on your blocks. Come down on one knee and then the other. And then just sit to the side. There you go. All right, so I'm going to use this block and I'm going to put it right there. And I'm going to lay back. And you can do it the opposite way. You can put it after you lay down, so you can lay down. Put your feet flat on the mat with your knees up and lift, and you can place it under there. So you don't want it up here under your spine, and you don't want it down here just under your buttocks. You just want it so it's resting right below your low spine, and it's putting good support under your buttocks. Okay, so this is a bridge pose. So now I'm going to put my legs down. So the whole purpose is to get a good low back stretch. I'm going to bring my shoulders, because Matt wants to curl up. My head is straight. If you're not comfortable with that, you can use your blanket under your head. My arms are going to be down at my side, or they can be out to the side. And we're just going to breathe here together for about 3 minutes. So go back to that breathing where you're breathing in and out through your nose to your count, but make the breaths even and let those thoughts go. Your next breath in, bring your knees back up with your feet flat on the floor, and carefully take the block out from underneath your back, and then you're going to bring your knees into your chest, reset your spine. And then we're going to go into our Shavasana pose. We're just going to do it for a couple of minutes, but you're welcome to stay in that pose longer if you'd like. So flat on your back, your hands to the side, palms up, feet relaxed away from each other. This is your breathing time, time to just focus on your breath. You can put your blanket over you. On your breath for another minute. Start wiggling your fingers and your toes. Your shoulders, maybe your ankles, and when you're ready, roll onto your right side or your left if it's easier for you to get up that way, whichever way is easier, because you're going to use, since I've rolled to the right, I'm going to use my left arm to push myself up and then my other arm. So whichever feels best. Come back to a seated position. Bring your hands to heart center. Thank you for coming and doing yoga with me and honoring your body. I wish peace and love for your mind, body, soul, and the greater beyond. Namaste.